This is a breaking news update from BoilingFrogsPost.com. Last week, NSA whistleblower Russell Tice conducted interviews on Boiling Frogs Post and The Corbett Report, where he revealed shocking new details of the NSA spying scandal. In addition to detailing how the NSA is collecting and storing the content of all electronic communications passing through the United States, he also revealed for the first time some of the specific targets of past NSA wiretapping operations, including senior congressional leaders, the former White House press secretary, high-ranking military generals, the entire Supreme Court, and even then-Senator from Illinois and future President Barack Obama.
Yeah, it was journalists. It was members of Congress, both houses, Senate and the House, especially on the intelligence committees, in the Armed Services committees, and on Judiciary committees. And as well as the senior leadership in both the House and the Senate. It was judges, federal judges, and every member of the Supreme Court, all nine, of which I held the initial targeting of Judge Alito in my hand when Judge Alito was being put up for his position on the Supreme Court. So I saw the Alito paperwork in my hand. Physically, it was members of a few members of Bush's own staff in the White House. Now, who else did they? They went after lots of lawyers and law firms, I noticed.
In your interview on Boiling Frogs Post, you mentioned specifically General Petraeus.
Yes, they went after senior military leaders. With my satellite stuff, I saw how they went after the State Department. They went after Colin Powell, Secretary of State. They went after General Sasaki, and then on the terrestrial side, I saw the paperwork as they were going after General Petraeus.
Was Barack Obama targeted by this?
Yes, he was. As a matter of fact, that was in 2004, probably late summer time frame. And he was a candidate for senator. He'd already won his primary in Illinois, and that's when I saw, Barack Obama's name.
Russell Tice was a 20-year intelligence analyst veteran, working for the NSA until 2005 when he helped blow the whistle on the agency's unconstitutional spying on Americans. He was one of the sources that James Risen and Eric Lichtblau turned to for their reporting on the warrantless wiretapping program in the New York Times. In 2009, he revealed to Keith Olbermann that the agency was eavesdropping on the communications of journalists a full 4 years before the AP spying scandal.
But an organization that was collected on were U.S. News organizations and reporters and journalists.
So far, the mainstream press in the United States have been studiously ignoring these amazing revelations. Tice was invited for a brief appearance on MSNBC, but was told just minutes before going on air that he was not permitted to mention the wiretapping of government officials. Glenn Greenwald and others who have been working tirelessly on the Edward Snowden story have yet to even acknowledge Tice's comments. A handful of publications such as the Huffington Post and Business Insider have run single stories on the revelations, but so far there has been no response from the NSA, the White House, or any of the other people named by Tice to these allegations. Stay tuned for continuing coverage of the story this week on BoilingFrogsPost.com.
We are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.